Our HOD is not giving.
What?
There was problem. Good morning. Yes. Yes, Bagal. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, where we are? Yes. Which chapter is going on? Are you knowing? Which chapter is going on? Yes. Are you observing screen?
Yes, sir.
What it is written on the screen?
Friction.
Frictional or friction?
Friction.
Friction. So today we are going to see last part of second chapter. What is the name of our second chapter? Yes. What is the name?
Equilibrium of radial bow.
Very good. Equilibrium. And what was the name of our first chapter? Rule number 3. First chapter.
Resultant of coplanar.
Very good. Resultant of coplanar forces. This is our second chapter. Means in first chapter we have studied how to find the resultant in all cases. Many more problems we have solved in this equilibrium. This is the name of the chapter. We can see in short equilibrium or equilibrium of rigid bodies. Last part is we are going to see today, that is friction. So whether you have studied before this, what is friction? So do you know something about friction, Shubham? Are you knowing
two surfaces are against each other?
Ha, correct. So in this chapter, if you'll see, so we have started the chapter with equilibrium. What is equilibrium and what is the difference between how equilibrium is come? So many more things we have seen. After that, we have solved the problems of cylinder, sphere, and we have found out the reaction. Most important thing in this chapter is what? Most important thing is what? When a particular body is in equilibrium, conditions of equilibrium will come into picture. That is the most important thing from this chapter. And what was the conditions of equilibrium? When body is in summation fx is equal to 0, summation fy is equal to 0, and summation of moment due to all forces is equal to 0. Because body is in equilibrium. So we have seen what is equilibrium. Equilibrium is nothing but irrespective of application of forces, body is in stationary condition, we can say, or it is at the rest. Though the forces are applied on the body, it is not, neither it is displacing, neither it is rotating. That's a simple phenomenon is known as, what it is known as? Equilibrium.
Equilibrium.
So we have seen again many more problems, etc., theory. So today we are going to see friction. So very simple again. Friction is a one type of force. So as we discussed earlier in this subject at the starting few lectures, without force our subject will not come into picture. So whenever there is a force, there is mechanics, we can say, in other words. So what is friction? Definition is given. What is friction? Friction is a force between two surfaces that are sliding or trying to slide across each other. Friction is a force between two surfaces that are sliding or trying to slide across each other. Force between two surfaces. When we are going to slide or trying to slide, it is called as friction. For example, when you try to push a book along the floor, so maybe on the table, floor, friction makes it difficult. So friction will come into picture. It is nothing but a type of force. So I will say here most important thing is what? Friction is nothing but a force generated between surfaces when we are going to move it somewhere on the floor, etc. So that is nothing but the friction. It is a force, another name of force, which occurs into the surfaces. So friction always works in the direction, whether this thing was known to you. Most important thing as far as friction is concerned, whenever friction always works in the direction opposite to the direction in which object is moving or tried to move, whether this thing was known to you.
Yes sir.
So here a particular suppose
yes, sir.
This thing is also most important as far as friction is there. So suppose there is a body A. Now I am going to pull this body by force P towards right hand side. So where the frictional force will act, whether this thing is known to you. So what was the, if, so I will repeat this example again. There is a one floor, I will say, this floor I have shown at the bottom, and on that one object is placed. Suppose that object is A, and I am trying to pull this object towards right hand side by application of P force. So where, what will be the direction of frictional force or friction, I will say? Friction.
Left hand side.
Opposite to P means here it will be in this way. Frictional force, it is opposite. So this thing is also known to you. So this thing is also you should keep in mind, whenever friction always works, whenever there is a friction, its direction is opposite to the direction in which object is moving or trying to move. So this is again most important thing. So examples, many more examples are there. Rubbing both hands together to create heat. We can rub the hand maybe in particular in winter season. So we can generate heat. Examples, day-to-day life, a sliding table across the floor. If you are going to slide the table across floor, friction will come into picture. Many more. Even, are you knowing? We can, how, what makes things to us to walk on the floor? आपल्याला चालण्यासाठी सुद्धा फ्रिक्शन पाहिजे, अदरवाइज वी मे गेट स्किल्ड. आर यू गेटिंग? ऑन विच बेसिस आर ऑन वी आर वॉकिंग ऑन द फ्लोर ड्यू टू वॉट? ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शन. अगेन देर इज अ फ्रिक्शन. इवन वी कॅन से व्हीकल्स आर मुव्हिंग ऑन द रोड ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शन. अगेन वी कॅन से फ्रिक्शन विल कम इन टू पिक्चर. विदाउट फ्रिक्शन नथिंग. इफ देर इज नो फ्रिक्शन दॅट विल गो इन वी कॅन से स्किडिंग विल हॅपन. Something like this. So this is a friction. Friction is a force between two surfaces that are sliding or trying to slide, that we have seen. Some students are still joining, that's why I will repeat again. Friction is a force between two surfaces that are sliding or trying to slide across. Each other. So examples, you try to push a book along floor, maybe friction always works opposite. This is most important thing. It works on this principle also. We are going to solve some problems. Opposite to direction in which the object is moving, and examples are there, different examples. Are you getting? So next one is advantages and disadvantages. So what is the advantages of friction? Rule number 51, we will read. What is the advantages of friction? Let me know. Huh? Sudarshan.
Friction is responsible for many types of motion.
Very good.
It helps us walk on the ground.
Oh, same thing we have discussed.
Brakes in a car makes use of friction to stop the car.
Very good.
It helps in the generation of heat when we rub our hands.
Very good. Thank you. So what are the advantages of friction? Very simple. So friction is responsible for many motion. I have told vehicles are moving on the road due to friction. Are you getting? So what will happen? Suppose there is a, on the surface, there is, I will say, very smooth surface, something like ice. So whether there is ice floor, suppose ice, we can say, is it whether vehicles will move if there is very smooth surface, something like we can say mirror finish. It may get skid, we will say. So without friction, motion is not possible. So what the way vehicles are moving, it helps us walk on the ground. So we can walk on the ground due to friction only. If there is no friction, we can slip, I will say, SLIP. SLIP, so slip means SLIP. Yeah? This also you have to keep in mind. Do you know? Yeah. Otherwise, we make it slip on the floor. If there is very smooth surface, so this slip and another slip, your favorite. So which is your favorite? First one or second one?
Second one,
very good. But now this friction will make us, first one, it will play a role in our friction. This one is something different, though it is favorite. It will not come into picture. It helps in generation of heat. Once we are going to rub the hand. Disadvantages. So very simple. Only theory is there in this. It may ask it, what is friction? What are its advantages and disadvantages of friction? So there is no, I will say, rocket science in this. Very simple. Disadvantages. Who will help me to read these disadvantages? So that I will come to know that you are attending very sincerely. Nikhil, will you read 24 roll number? 24. Or only logged in. Sunil Kadam, 26.
Yes, sir.
Will you read loudly? Disadvantages, yes, of friction.
Friction produces unnecessary heat leading to the wastage of energy.
Okay, very good. Unnecessary heat may get generated and wastage of energy will happen. That is first one. Next one.
The force of friction acts in the opposite direction of motion. So friction slows down the motion of moving objects.
Very good. So as we see in opposite direction, friction always acts in opposite direction of the motion. So what will happen? A friction slows down the motion, or in other words, what we will say, if at all we want to move apart, more energy will require if there is more friction. Are you getting? If there is more friction, more energy is required, or it is slowing down the motion. Next.
Forest fires are caused due to the friction between tree branches.
Branches. In your geometry, you might have seen this. So our subject is not geometry, but it is a disadvantage. Whenever there was a friction between branches of the trees, forest fire. Next.
A lot of money goes into preventing friction and the usual wear and tear caused by it by using techniques like greasing and oiling.
Okay, a lot of money goes into preventing friction and usual wear and tear. So a simple example I will give. Why it is necessary to change tires of our vehicles, two-wheelers, etc. Why always that gone wear and tear? Due to friction, we will say. Again, due to friction. Lot of money goes into in such a way. Because due to friction, wear and tear. So this term is also famous to you. Wear and tear is happening. Not only in case of tires, but other parts also that needs to be changed after use or again and again. Once it is getting damaged, we will say wear and tear. So that is a lot of money is going, forest fires happening, the friction of force as it is acting opposite direction to applied force, more energy is required to move the part or it is slowing down the motion. Again, friction produces unnecessarily heat. So these are the disadvantages. So again, pure theory. So only pure theory is there in this. Again, advantages and disadvantages. There is no, we can say, much difficult thing to discuss. Shall we go next? What is friction we have seen? Again, those who have joined late, for them I will repeat. So we have started the point, last part of chapter number 2, friction, in which we have seen what is the friction. So force between two surfaces when we are going to slide. When force will come into picture, friction will come into picture. When you try to push, examples are there. And here only one thing we have seen. So always direction of force is opposite to applied force. So that is important. And examples are given, rubbing of head, sliding, etc. Examples. So what is friction? What are its advantages? And what are these disadvantages? Next one. What is there in this slide? frictional force and its significance. Frictional force. So what does it mean by frictional force? So frictional force is a resistive force developed between two surfaces in contact when motion takes place among them. So whatever, in short, shall I say frictional force is nothing but resistance to the motion? In short, frictional force is nothing but resistance to the motion in electrical or electronics engineering, something that resistance you are saying. Resistance, no? R you are noting, and it is shown by something like this, no? That in your electrical or somewhere, maybe in physics also, this comes. R we are showing, no? So what was that resistance? What was the definition of that resistance? Here, frictional force is a resistive force, we can say, opposed to the motion. What was the definition of that resistance in your electrical engineering or somewhere?
Opposition to current.
Opposition to current. Very good. There, we can say opposition to current. Here, we are saying opposition to motion, we will say. When there is a motion between two parts and whatever oppose will happen, it is nothing but frictional force. Due to frictional force only, oppose is happening, we can say. So again, that resistance, your electrical or electronics, whatever that resistance, it is having some diameter, etc., material, etc. Forget about it. Factors on which frictional resistance depends are as follows. So which are they? So most important thing, nature of surface in contact. What is the nature of surface in contact? This is most important thing. Magnitude of applied force, it is depends upon magnitude applied between the forces, and normal reaction between contact surfaces. What is the normal reaction? Factors on which frictional resistance or friction is depend. So nature of surface, how surface is. More the rough surface, more will be what? More the rough, we will say. More the rough surface, more will be friction, or less will be the friction?
More friction.
Now here, what will be the relation if we'll think a little? Magnitude of applied force?
Directly proportional.
Directly proportional, very good. And then what will be the, so this we are going to see next. Normal reaction, what is the relation? So that is there next. Okay, so this is frictional force, is nothing but resistive force developed between two surfaces in contact, and on which basis it is applied, nature of surface, magnitude, and normal reaction. Next, classification of or types of friction. So classification, only we should know what is the, how it is classified. So mainly it is classified into two types. Yeah. Mainly it is divided into two types. One is motion. So one type is motion, another one is surface condition. So these two types, one is motion, another one is surface condition. Actually, whatever we are going to see, it is static and dynamic. So what does mean by static? Static friction, it occurs when body is at rest and tends to move. It may happen, you may say, if body is in motion, how friction will happen? So it may come, a question may arise in your mind. First type is classification based on motion. Second type is classification based on surface condition. And in that again, in motion, static friction. So we have seen what the statistics, statics, not statistics, is a part of mathematics. Statics means what? When body is in motion, we have seen in mechanics. When body is in motion, we are calling it as a statics. But a simple question may arise in your mind. If body is in motion, body is in stationary position or is at rest, how friction will come into picture? So it is mentioned in the bracket. It occurs when body is at rest, okay. But tends to move, means body is about to move. In that case, this friction will come into picture, static. And what about dynamic friction? It occurs when there is a relative motion between. So there is a motion. That's why it is called as dynamic friction. So as we have seen, static and dynamic, only this is important for our subject. Static friction, dynamic friction. And again, there are two types of dynamic friction. Sliding friction and rolling friction. Sliding, it occurs when body slides over each other. and a rolling friction, it occurs when body roll over each other. So are you knowing the difference between sliding and rolling? Sliding and rolling.
Yes.
So that we can see sliding. Sliding means only one part and another part is dragged, in I will say, in other words, dragged. And rolling, both the parts are rotating on each other. Something like this, rotating. So it may an example of rolling friction. And based on surface condition, actually it is not our part right now. Surface condition, still you can know what is the condition of surface, dry friction and wet friction. It occurs when surfaces in contact are dry. And another one, it occurs when surfaces are, whatever contacts are there, these are wet, something like this. Actually, this second part is not, now it is, we are not going to see in syllabus, so it is not there. First part, static dynamic only. And again, two parts of dynamic, sliding and rolling. That's all. So what are the different types of friction? What is friction? Okay, what are the advantages of friction? What are the disadvantages of friction? Then classification of friction, theory only. So these are the types of friction. Either you can take screenshot or you can write this. Shall we go next?
Yes, sir.
Next. Laws of static friction. So for our information, I have kept in front of each other. So some of the part for this may be common. It is not difference. So laws of friction, instead of preparing separately, I have prepared only in one slide. So laws of friction, laws of static friction and laws of dynamic friction. It is not difference, I would say. So for our information, just I have collected. So whether you have studied in your physics, etc., what are the laws of friction? So maybe you have studied some introductory part of friction. So first law, the force of friction always acts in the direction opposite to the direction of motion. So as we discussed in the introductory part of this, what was that? Friction, it is opposite to the direction of motion or applied force, I will say. Same is case, the force of friction always act the direction opposite to the same. So that's why I have told in initial only, it is not difference. Laws of friction, 5 laws, laws of static friction, laws of dynamic friction, 5 points. So we have collected here collectively. The magnitude of force of friction is exactly equal to the force which tends to move body. Means whatever force is applied, we have seen. Whatever force is applied, same frictional force will be exist for a body A. Suppose I have applied force P. So similarly here, yep. So F is equal to P. It is as simple as this. The magnitude of kinetic friction bears, so that is different point. Let us first complete laws of static friction. Then the magnitude of limiting friction bears a constant ratio to the normal reaction. Means a body is placed on the table, suppose, and whatever frictional force is occurring, yep, it bears a constant ratio with the reaction. Now this reaction term is all now you are knowing. So this is a common ratio, or we can say constant ratio, not common. It bears a constant ratio with normal reaction. So that is third point from the laws of static friction. Force of friction depends upon the roughness of surface. It is but obvious. So we have seen force of friction depends upon nature of surface or roughness of surface. Force of friction does not depend upon shape and area of contact. So how much area is in contact? It does not depend upon area of contact and shape. What is the shape of object? So these are the laws of static friction. Then you will see laws of dynamic friction. The force of friction always acts in direction opposite. It is common to both. The magnitude of kinetic friction bears a constant ratio to the normal reaction. So magnitude of friction force, again, this point is similar to the static friction. Static friction is always greater than dynamic friction. Static friction is always greater than dynamic friction. So who will give an example for this? Static friction is always greater than dynamic friction. Are you imagining, or can anybody try to give explanation for this. Static friction is always greater than dynamic friction. What is static friction and dynamic friction? What we have seen? Static friction means what? Body is at the rest, but it is about to move. Are you getting? And what is dynamic friction? Bodies are in motion. Bodies are in motion. Okay. So what will be the example of this? Can anybody? Here it is told that static friction is always greater than the dynamic friction. Can anybody try to explain this? How it will be? Can anybody? Sunil, 26 roll number. Again, who is there? Akash Kambali, 28. Are you able to? Can you?
In dynamic, there is a speed, so friction is less.
Very good. Almost 99%, or we can say 100%. There is a speed, that's why friction is less. And then what is happening in static?
It is on rest, so friction is great.
Very good. It is at the rest. Example, I will tell now to understand. Suppose there is one tractor. Shall I tell in Marathi or in English? There is one tractor. Something like this. Tractor is there. It is at stationary. Tractor banda padla hai samjha. And four persons are required to move it. Four persons are required to move the tractor. Ek tractor banda padlela hai market sangto. Ne aplyala chalu karayche manje dhaklayche hai pudu. Tar pahile tar four persons lagtil. Four persons. Manje to stationary hai move kela pudu challa. Ekda pudu challa ka समजा मी एक माणूस काढला किंवा इथून एक माणूस बाजूला केला किंवा दोन केले मायनस टू केले तर दोन माणसं ढकलू शकतील का हा ट्रॅक्टर नंतर एकदा पुढे पळायला लागल्यावर. व्हॉट इज युअर इमॅजिनेशन?
यस सर.
इट मे हॅपन. म्हणजे एकदा हा स्टेशनरी मधून मुव्हिंग केला त्याच्यानंतर मी दोन माणसं बाजूला केली इथून दोनच माणसं ढकलू शकतील का हा ट्रॅक्टर? किती जणांना वाटतंय की इज इट यस दिस इज पॉसिबल की चारच्या माणसांच्या ऐवजी दोनच माणसं नंतर त्याची मोशन कंटिन्यू करू शकतील असं किती जणांना वाटतं?
यस सर.
यस सर.
यस सर.
इट मे हॅपन. नो इट मे हॅपन और इट इज फिक्सडली हॅपन. म्हणजे बंद पडलेला ट्रॅक्टर मुव्हिंग करेपर्यंत आपल्याला जास्त फोर्स लागतोय. इफ इट इज ऍट द स्टेशनरी इफ वी वॉन्ट टू मूव्ह फोर पर्सन्स आर रिक्वायर्ड टू मूव्ह इट. वन्स इट विल स्टार्ट मुव्हिंग वी कॅन रिड्यूस द नंबर ऑफ persons. In our language, I will say we can reduce the force thereafter once it will be in motion. That two persons can move the tractor, we will say. That is the simple. Why it is called static friction is always greater than dynamic friction? Because body is at the rest and we want to move. That's why more force is required. In short, more friction. Whenever there is a force, friction will come into picture. Static friction will be more than dynamic friction. That is the simple example. Father, if you have experienced well and good, if not, it is correct. The body, suppose the structure is at the stationary, if you want to move, start its motion, initially it may require four persons. Once the tractor will start moving, two persons may continue that motion. Once it is in motion. So less friction, we will say. In other words, in case of force, we will say, initially more force is required. More force, more friction. And when there is less force, less friction. That's why static friction is always greater than dynamic friction. That is the reason why it is happening. And then ratio of F upon R, it is common to, it is slightly less than limiting friction because reaction is less. Then, for moderate speed of the force, friction remains constant but decrease the with the increase of speed. For moderate speed, force of friction remains constant but decrease with increase in speed. In other words, when there is more motion, less friction, we can say. If there is a lot of speed is there, automatically friction may go on decreasing. So that is the reason why it is called something like this. So for our information, you can note down this. So laws of static friction, this is not difference. Though I have written in one column laws of static friction, laws of dynamic friction. So why it is so? So it may happen something like this. Okay. Next. limiting equilibrium and limiting friction. Limiting equilibrium and limiting friction, we can see. So what is this? So this terminology is also the condition in which body is just on the point of motion in direction of applied force. It is called as limiting equilibrium. Limiting equilibrium means highest condition of equilibrium, we will say. Highest condition of equilibrium. Equilibrium means stationary. Equilibrium of means stationary, or a body is at rest irrespective of applied force. We have seen applied force, in case of applied force. That's why the condition in which body is just on the point of motion or just about to move, I will say. Body is at the rest, but due to applied force, body is just about to move. That's why it is called as limiting equilibrium. Equilibrium, we have seen limiting equilibrium. Then applied force is equal to friction. Then, so we can apply conditions of equilibrium because body is at the rest. It is just about to motion. That's why we can apply in limiting equilibrium, we can apply conditions of equilibrium. And we are knowing what are the conditions of equilibrium. Limiting friction, the maximum friction that can be generated between two static surfaces in contact is called as with each other is defined as limiting friction. And when maximum friction will come into picture, we have seen right now when body is at, when maximum friction will come into picture, when body is in motion or body is in body is when body is at the rest, maximum friction will come into picture. Friction is a self-adjusting force. It will be generated so that limiting equilibrium is achieved till the reaches to the limiting friction. Till this point, no motion will take place. Once force applied is greater than limiting friction, motion will occur. Are you getting? So it is as simple as this. Once force applied is greater than limiting friction, or we can say friction, motion will occur. Means applied force is more than friction. Automatically, object will start to move. For two dry surfaces in statics, limiting friction is a product of a normal reaction and coefficient of friction that we are going to see further. Two dry surfaces example is given. So here we can say limiting friction means what? Maximum friction between two surfaces. So if that maximum friction is less than applied force, if it is less than applied force, or we can say applied force is more than friction, body will start to move. It is as simple as this. So limiting equilibrium, it is the condition of body when body is about to move. It is called as limiting equilibrium. And limiting friction, maximum friction that can be generated between two static surfaces in contact. So what is next? So this term is also, so what is this coefficient of friction? So have you heard about this? What is coefficient of friction and how, by which letter or which symbol we are showing?
Yes, sir.
In laws of friction, we have seen the limiting friction F is directly proportional to normal reaction R. So this is the one law of friction. So from that law, what we can write, force of friction is directly proportional to normal reaction. So automatically, if we want to remove this proportionality sign, F is equal to mu into R. And what this mu is known as, the constant of proportional is known as coefficient of friction mu. So constant is known as coefficient of friction mu. The constant ratio of frictional force and resultant reaction is known as coefficient of friction. Very, very important formula here. First formula from the our this friction. F is equal to mu into R. What will be the unit of, we will say mu in this case. So frictional force will be measured in Newton. How, in which unit we are measuring reaction? Again, suppose Newton. Only Newton. So what will be the unit of mu? So it don't have unit.
Unitless.
So it has no unit or it is unitless, and it is a scalar quantity. Coefficient of friction. So whether this thing is known to you depends on the object in the contact and their roughness, its range is 0 to 1 for multiple choice question. This is most important. The range of coefficient of friction is 0 to 1. It is varies from 0 to 1. Okay. So this also the things you should remember. So F upon R.
You need to be F upon R then, sir.
It's so like that. Mu is equal to, this is wrong, no? This, no?
Yes, sir.
Here, mu is equal to
F upon R.
F upon R, correct. Thank you. So this should be there. F upon R. Mu is equal to F upon R. Okay, very simple. So this might have studied. It may be just a revision. Limiting friction and normal reaction are directly proportional to each other. F is directly proportional to R. Constant of proportionality is called as mu. It is unitless and scalar quantity. So this thing also you can remember. So first formula from this. F is equal to mu R is the first formula from this. So we can see this. Next. What is there next? Angle of friction. What does it mean by angle of friction? What is the sign or symbol? What is the symbol?
Phi.
Phi is the symbol. Angle of friction is, so what is this angle of friction? When body is in limiting equilibrium. When body is in limiting equilibrium. What is meant by limiting equilibrium? What is meant by limiting equilibrium?
Body is just on the point of motion.
Very good. Body is about to move, I will say. Body is just about to move due to applied force. That is the condition is known as limiting equilibrium. When body is in limiting equilibrium, then angle between the resultant reaction. So here resultant reaction is shown by S. Resultant reaction and normal reaction. Normal reaction means our regular reaction. And its resultant is called as angle of friction. It is denoted by phi. It is again dimensionless quantity. Resultant reaction. So how we can give resultant reaction? If there is a one body. So in figure you can see body is kept on one surface. Body is just kept on the one surface. And force P is applied for the body to pull it. Force P is applied, its weight is W. So whatever reaction will be happen, so it will be opposite to this. Actually, this reaction will be something like this, no? R, whatever we have seen. So here it is shown something like this. So here, this force F is there. So parallel force, if I will draw here something like this, parallel force. Okay, so we know this. So this will be F. So yes, resultant reaction is shown by yes letter. So yes is equal to under root R square plus F square. So if you will take phi, tan phi. So what will be the formula for tan phi in this triangle? F upon R. Front side is F and its adjacent side. So whatever this is R. So F upon R. So tan phi. So it is given something like this. So in what is the angle of friction? So it is the angle made by or angle between resultant reaction and normal reaction, or angle made by resultant with vertical, like this also we can say, or angle between resultant reaction S and normal reaction R. So this also we can take angle. What is the angle of friction? So it is denoted by phi, dimensionless quantity. So here S is a resultant reaction. It is given by R square plus F square, and then phi is equal to F upon R. So this is angle of friction. Shall we go next? Lot of theory is there in this. Are you with me? 35?
Yes, sir.
Are you listening? Yes. Only I am talking, nobody is talking. That's why I am. Next now. What it is? What is the title next? Relation between coefficient of friction, by which symbol we are showing coefficient of friction?
Mu.
And angle of friction?
Mu. Phi.
So there is one surface. Let us consider following figure. So there is one surface on which one body is placed. It is pulled by force P. It is pulled by force P. Once we are going to pull by force P along this surface, actually along this surface, frictional force will come into picture in opposite direction. But for an it is equal and opposite, equal in magnitude and opposite in direction with applied force P. So that's why it is shown through. That's why it is shown like something like collinear forces. So this figure, so whatever weight of this body is there, it will be in vertically downward. So it is shown by W, and the normal reaction equal and opposite with this W will be R. So like this. So from the figure, as we have seen, tan phi is equal to F upon R. So this is F. This particular side is our F side. F. So tan phi we have seen. So from this triangle, tan phi is equal to F upon R. Also, mu is equal to. Also, so as we have seen, so what is the definition of coefficient of friction? So we have seen frictional force is directly proportional to what?
Normal reaction.
Normal reaction. That's why. So this F upon R we can replace with mu. So what will happen? Tan phi is equal to mu. So this is mu. The relation. This is the relation between simple. This is the relation between tan our angle of friction phi and normal reaction. So this is second formula. I will say which first formula we have seen. Frictional force is equal to what?
Mu R.
This was our first. This was our first problem, or we can say first
formula.
Then first. This was our first and second. We have seen what was that? Now first, second one. Mu is equal to tan phi. Second, and also tan phi is equal to that. Also, we have seen tan phi. So this formula we have to remember. What was the formula? Tan phi is equal to F upon
R.
What is F?
Friction.
Which type of force?
Force of friction.
We can say or frictional force. Simply, force of friction or frictional force. Like that also you can say. So this is the relation. So from this conclusion, from this slide is mu is equal to tan phi. Mu is equal to tan phi is the relation. So from this. Now, what is this? Angle of repose. Whether this term have you came across? What is angle of repose and by what symbol it is shown?
Alpha.
So angle of repose. So have you came across this term? This may be the I think new for you.
Yes, sir.
This may be
no,
the
sir.
New. No? Already you have heard this term? Angle of repose?
No, sir.
Not no. Heard. Very good. So this is new term, angle of repose. What does it? And it is shown by alpha. So what is this angle of repose? It is the angle made by incline the plane. Means whatever in your maybe 11th or 12th or whatever may be the class. Whatever you have seen, in all cases, that surface was horizontal, either horizontal, we can say. Only horizontal. But whatever problems we are going to see in it, that case, that particular surface or particular plane may be inclined. It is not necessary, it should be always horizontal. So one step ahead. So it is an angle made by inclined plane with the horizontal. When the body placed on the plane, it is just on the point of moving down the plane due to its own weight. So the angle made by the inclined plane with the horizontal. This is up to this, you can see in the definition. Angle made by the inclined plane with the horizontal. Here one plane is shown, AB. So are you observing plane AB, which is inclined one, and it is making angle here, it is shown alpha. It is making angle alpha with the horizontal. But condition is that when the body is placed on the plane, it is just on the point of moving down the plane due to its own weight. So here force is not applied. Are you observing? Here force is not applied to the body to move, but when the body is going to start to move downward due to its own weight, that angle is known as angle of repose. So are you getting? So for a particular plane, any body is placed, so there will be only one angle, we can say. At a particular angle, that body will start to move downward. Due to what? Due to applied force or due to its own weight?
Due to its own weight.
At that angle is known as angle of repose. That angle is known as angle of repose. So body just on the point of motion in downward direction. Downward direction due to component of self-weight or due to its self-weight. So we have not applied, are you observing here? A force is not applied on this body. So whatever body is there, force is not applied on the body. Still, body is about to move in downward direction. Why? In this direction. Why? Due to its own weight. Body is on the point of motion due to its own weight. That angle is known as, what is the name of that angle?
Angle of repose.
That angle is known as angle of repose. Are you getting? So angle made by inclined plane with the horizontal when body is about to move in downward direction due to its own weight. Very simple. Angle of repose. Shall we go next?
Lot of theories there.
Angle of repose. So you can take screenshot when I have erased all. Angle of repose. Next. Relation between. Can anybody read? Relation between?
Angle of friction, phi, and angle of repose, alpha.
Very good. Relation between angle of friction, phi, and angle of repose, alpha. So what is angle? So here, if you see the figure, there is one body which is placed on inclined plane AB. So just see, there is one inclined plane AB on which this body is placed. Okay. And that alpha is given angle of repose. Means it is just about to move. That particular body is about to move in downward direction. So that particular weight of body will act through its CG, center of gravity, or at midpoint we will say W weight, and whatever reaction is there, that is R. So if I will define all the terms here at the start, looking to the figure, from figure, if I will define all the terms from this, okay. So AB is, what is AB? Inclined plane. So from figure. So different terms we should define. What are the different terms? From the figure, I will say AB. AB is inclined plane. Okay. Inclined plane. W. What is W? Weight of body.
Yes.
Okay. So what will be the R? Reaction, which will be perpendicular to weight. R. Which reaction we have to say? R is normal reaction.
R is normal reaction.
Then, if you will consider mu is a coefficient of friction between this body and plane AB. So here you are knowing coefficient of friction. So all terms you are knowing. Coefficient of friction. What is alpha? Angle made by? What is alpha? What is the name of alpha? What? Which angle we are saying?
Angle of repose.
And what is that angle? What is the definition? Angle made by inclined plane with the
horizontal surface.
With the horizontal surface. But what is the condition?
Because of its own weight.
Body should move because of its own weight. That is the angle of repose, I will say here. Angle of repose. Okay. So the angle made by the reaction. So as we know, if you see the figure now, these components are already here So this angle alpha, there is no question. At point A, there is angle of alpha. So this particular reaction now, plane AB is inclined 1. This plane is AB inclined 1. This particular W force is vertically downward. Vertically downward. It is going vertically downward. Okay. And normal reaction will come. Normal to the this perpendicular to AB. Okay. So how this alpha will come? Alpha. How this angle? So one thing I have told. The angle made by. Angle made by inclined plane with horizontal. Angle made by inclined plane with horizontal. And angle made by normal with vertical. Normal vertical. So here, that equation we should remember. Otherwise, we can calculate also. Plane with horizontal. Plane with horizontal. This angle is equal to. Plane ne horizontal se angle ke lela ha. Kasha shi equal asto? Normal ne. Normal ne. Normal with. Normal by. A vertical like this. There is one equation in mechanics. Ekada plane ne horizontal se kelela angle ha normal reaction ne vertical se kelela angle equal asto. This is there. So that's why this vertical will make alpha. So if we want to calculate, suppose this triangle A, here B is there, C and D. What will be the angle at D? Ha angle kiti elo? This angle. If you consider A, D, C,
90 minus alpha.
It will come 90 minus alpha. 90 minus alpha. Now, if I will consider particular this triangle, suppose I will give here, suppose something O, here D, and suppose here I will give E as the name. So ODE, how many angles are known to you now? ODE, this one will be 90.
90.
This one is 90 minus alpha. So what will be remaining angle? एक 90 आहे दुसरा 90 minus alpha आहे. So what will be this angle?
Alpha.
It will be automatic alpha because addition of this angle and this should be 90. So 90 minus alpha plus alpha, alpha alpha will get cancelled. Likewise, it will remain 90. Means this angle will be 90. So in our mechanics, there is one equation. एकदा plane ने horizontal से केलेला angle हा, त्याच plane चा normal ने vertical से केलेला angle असतो. Equal. These two angles are equal. Plane ne horizontal si, normal ne vertical si. Kelela angle hai equal asto. So it is shown like this. That's only it is shown. Otherwise there is no, we can say nothing. Same thing is there only. Okay. Plane ne horizontal si ani normal ne vertical si kelela angle ha kasa asto equal. So these two angles are equal. Okay, so here now what we will do, resolving the forces along the B. Now here again resolution will be there in all the problems hereafter. Only resolution will not be there along horizontal and vertical. Whatever problems we are going to say, in all problems resolution will come into picture, but it is not along horizontal and along vertical. But it is along the plane and perpendicular to plane. Likewise, the resolution is going to come into picture. Manje apan kay karnar ahot ata? In all cases, here also resolution is going to come, but along the plane and perpendicular to plane, which is our plane in this particular. It is not problem actually, it is a little derivation. Which plane we have considered? Plane?
AB.
Plane AB. Now, so how many forces are there? How many forces are there? So here force is not applied. So if I will ask at this stage, how many forces are coming picture, are coming to picture on body? Kiti forces hai to? Including reaction, friction, weight. How many are there? Maybe reactions, forces. One is R, normal reaction. Okay. One is force, this. Frictional force, and another is weight. Anything is there apart from this F, R, and W. Anything is there?
Hard
weight is resolved into component.
Yes, weight is resolved because as far as body along the plane, neither it is along the plane and perpendicular to plane. Is the figure pile letter, you may come to know that this W is, though it is vertical, though it is vertical in our normal circumstances, as far as plane AB is concerned, neither it is along the plane and perpendicular to plane. Asa manu kami, this W force or weight, neither it is along the plane or perpendicular to plane. Asa manu kami, shall I say like this?
Yes, sir.
That's why in our normal circumstances, we can say this force is inclined over. Because what we are considering now, plane AB, our main source is plane AB. So we have to resolve this particular W weight along the plane and perpendicular to plane. So what will be that component along the, or we can say along this R reaction, because angle we found out with that reaction R. So here automatically it will come W cos alpha. So why it is W cos alpha? Because angle made with that particular axis is alpha. And perpendicular to it is W sin alpha. Any problem at this stage? So W cos alpha, W sin alpha. Means, is there any problem? W cos alpha, W sin alpha. And if now, only one force it was inclined in the system, I will say. Only one force as far as plane AB is concerned. Only one force. And if now I have resolved W cos alpha, W sin alpha, now I can take summation fx and summation fy along the plane, considering plane AB. So here, most important thing, considering plane AB as a reference, considering plane AB as reference. So what will be now, first let us apply conditions. Apply conditions of equilibrium. Apply condition of equilibrium. Okay, so what will it be? Let me tell, summation apex, I will say in short, or I will say summation of forces along AB. Forces along AB means in short apex along AB equal to zero. Okay, so what will be that? We will tell which forces are acting along plane AB. Looking to the figure.
F and F, W sin alpha.
F and W sin alpha. F and W sin alpha. So what will be the equation? Which force will be positive, which will be negative?
W sin alpha negative and F positive.
F positive. So F is positive. W sin
alpha
equal to zero. Equal to zero. So from this we can say F is equal to. So what will
W
be
W sin alpha?
W sin alpha.
Sin alpha.
Equation number one. Now resolving the forces, summation of forces perpendicular to the AB equal to zero. Which forces are acting perpendicular to AB or normal to AB?
R and W cos alpha.
R and W cos alpha. So which force will be positive, which will be negative? Something like our positive y-axis, negative y-axis.
Negative
y-axis.
R positive and W cos alpha negative.
Okay. R will be positive and W
cos alpha negative.
Equal to zero. From this, R is equal to what will be R?
W cos alpha.
W cos alpha equation number two. So two simple equation we got. One is F is equal to W sin alpha. Another one is R is equal to W cos alpha. Divide equation one by two. So divide. So what will happen? Very simple. Divide equation one by two. What will happen?
N alpha.
N alpha is equal to N alpha. N alpha
equal to
tan
alpha. Equal to tan alpha. But F upon R, what is the value of F upon R?
Mu.
Mu. So Therefore, I will write here mu is equal to tan alpha. Mu is equal to tan alpha. So one relation we have seen. One more. Actually, this is up to this. Our this derivation we will say simple derivation is over up to this. So again, if you will see, what is the relation between coefficient of friction mu and angle of friction phi?
Tan phi is equal to mu.
Tan phi is equal to mu.
So here I will write since F upon R is equal to mu, and what is the relation between phi and mu?
Tan phi is equal to mu.
Also, tan phi is equal to mu.
Mu.
So what will happen in this equation?
So tan alpha is equal to
tan phi. Tan alpha is equal to tan phi.
So what will happen then? Tan alpha is equal to
tan phi.
Tan alpha is equal to tan phi. So what will be the relation? So from this can what I can say alpha and what is the relation between alpha and phi then?
Alpha is equal to phi.
Because from this I will say alpha is equal to phi. Alpha is equal to phi. So this is the relation between angle of repose and angle of which? Friction. Angle of repose and angle of friction. Very simple. So in this all equations or all problems, not horizontal and vertical, resolution you are going to make along the plane and perpendicular to plane. Likewise, similar to our horizontal and vertical. So this is the relation between this angle of repose and angle of friction.
Friction.
Have you got? Very simple.
Yes, sir.
Shall we go next?
Yes, sir.
Have you noted down either take screenshot or note this?
Noted.
Shall we go next?
Sir, the lecture, na?
Ah.
Akravasta sir, the skin the special ornament, but sir lecture, na?
Kuna sir, kya aala ka message? Let me check.
Sir, FYB take la aala baga.
आता
काल आलाय सर
आता करा लेक्चर आहे वन मिनिट Which message? Scholarship from tomorrow? Where it is? I am not observing. Which lecture you are telling? List of student. Dear student, today Sunday is working. Where is the message?
Sorry, sir.
Where it is?
Delete zala, sir, the message.
Delete zala, ka? Till I will check if there is anything. After this, I will check. Shall we continue or shall we take break now?
Continue, sir.
Okay.
Break, sir.
Then again, I have to take election. Then how many are saying continue? I will check whether problems. We will see one or two problem. Then we will take break. Then we will take one lecture. Then we will stop.
Continue.
No, sir.
Continue.
Continue, sir. No problem.
No problem. Read them. First problem. So your CC is coming. I will see what is happening. Yes, sir.
Sir, at the earlier link.
Just now you got the link. Okay, then we will stop. And what? At what
time? At 11 a.m.
At 11 a.m.
5 minutes break.
5 minutes you take. Break
after
and afterwards
there will be lunch break and after lecture.
Okay, so we will stop for today's. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Attendance is mandatory. Message from your class coordinator. Attendance is mandatory for next session.